Imagine a skyscraper more than 3 times taller than the Eiffel Tower. A tower so high, it literally scrapes the edge of the sky. The world's first kilometer-high building is the Jeddah Tower, a megastructure that aims to rise over 1,000 meters above the sands of Saudi Arabia. It's been called many things: an engineering marvel, a symbol of national pride, and for a while, a stalled dream. But now, after years of silence and half-finished concrete, the Jeddah Tower is back in the spotlight, with bold ambitions to finish construction by 2028. So, what is this towering structure really about? And can it actually be built? The Jeddah Tower isn't just a skyscraper, it's the crown jewel of a $20 billion urban development called Jeddah Economic City, a massive new district being built just north of Saudi Arabia's coastal city of Jeddah. The idea? Create a new economic hub from scratch. Offices, apartments, hotels, shopping centers, green parks, all radiating out from this central landmark. The tower itself is planned to be over 1,000 meters tall, breaking the current world record held by the 828-meter Burj Khalifa in Dubai. But beyond the numbers, this tower is meant to make a statement. It's a physical symbol of Saudi Arabia's vision to diversify its economy, attract global attention, and show that it's not just part of the modern world, it's helping shape it. The original idea took shape in the mid-2000s, during a boom in Gulf megaprojects. The tower's development was spearheaded by Prince Al-Walid bin Talal, one of the kingdom's wealthiest and most influential businessmen. By 2013, construction had officially begun. The foundation was laid, and for a while, things were moving fast. By 2017, the building had reached 63 floors, a respectable height on its own. Then, in 2018, everything stopped. Saudi Arabia's anti-corruption crackdown reached top levels of the Jeddah Tower's development team. Payments stalled, contractors pulled out, and the site went quiet. For nearly 5 years, the project sat frozen, an unfinished skeleton in the desert. But in 2023, a new plan emerged. The project was revived, and now construction is set to resume in 2025. With a new team of international engineers and a renewed push to complete the tower by 2028. Building a kilometer-high tower is not just a matter of stacking steel and concrete. At that height, every meter introduces new challenges. The Jeddah Tower uses a Y-shaped floor plan designed to maximize stability and reduce wind loads. It's the same principle used in the Burj Khalifa, but scaled up. Below ground, things get even more extreme. The soil in Jeddah isn't ideal, a mix of limestone and coral rock. Engineers had to drill 270 concrete piles into the earth, some going 110 meters deep, just to find stable ground. On top of that sits a massive 5-meter-thick concrete mat, anchoring nearly 900,000 tons of structure. Wind tunnel testing was done to model air currents at extreme altitudes, while a super-thick concrete core runs up the center of the tower, reinforced with tuned mass dampers to reduce sway. It's a feat of structural engineering, unlike anything attempted before. Once construction resumes, the plan is to build one floor every 4 days. The bottom 600 meters will be poured using high-strength concrete. Above that, the top 350 meters will use structural steel, a lighter material better suited for altitude. Vertical transport is a major challenge, so the tower will be equipped with 5 double-deck elevators capable of moving at 10 meters per second, among the fastest in the world. 3 sky lobbies will allow passengers to transfer elevators midway, instead of running cables the full kilometer. And near the top, at 600 meters, there will be a massive observation deck, expected to be the highest in the world when finished. The tower isn't just about height. It's also designed with energy efficiency in mind. Its tapered shape reduces surface area exposed to the sun, casting its own shade and minimizing heat gain. The outer glass is highly reflective, bouncing sunlight, and keeping the interior cool. Meanwhile, the air conditioning system pulls in cool air from the upper levels and recycles condensed water to save energy. Even the elevators generate electricity on the way down, like a vertical version of regenerative braking in electric cars. Combined with smart lighting systems, the building is designed to use significantly less power than its massive size would suggest. Still, the road ahead is anything but smooth. At 1 kilometer, the air thins out. Materials behave differently. Concrete has to be pumped hundreds of meters straight up, a logistical nightmare. And then there's the money. The project has already seen years of delays and political complications. The COVID-19 pandemic only added to the uncertainty. Costs are rising, and the world economy looks very different from when this tower was first imagined. Even with revived plans, there's no guarantee that things will go as scheduled. If completed, the Jeddah Tower could set a new benchmark in engineering. One that opens the door to future vertical cities where land is scarce and populations grow upward instead of outward. For Saudi Arabia, it's also deeply symbolic. Part of Vision 2030, the tower represents a pivot away from oil and toward tourism, finance, and global attention. But there's a question worth asking. Is this really the future of urban development? Or is it a dramatic symbol meant more for headlines than for livability? Let us know what you think. Is this an engineering marvel or an overambitious gamble? If built, the Jeddah Tower will stand over 1,000 meters tall, higher than any structure humanity has ever attempted. It's a bold vision. One part architecture, one part geopolitics, and one part national identity. But big visions come with big risks. So, what do you think? Is this a leap into the future? Or just an extravagant way to say, look at me? Drop your thoughts in the comments. Hit like if you enjoy videos about massive engineering projects. And subscribe if you want to keep exploring the biggest and most ambitious structures on Earth.